vitamin B3 and skin cancer risk, what research is saying. While the US is just entering spring, summer has already begun in some territories where blistering heat is torture. But whatever season it is, your skin should be protected from extreme sunlight exposure to avoid skin cancer. Recently, an expert discussed why vitamin B3 is sometimes recommended to lower skin cancer risk. Should you be taking supplements? In the conversation, Deshan Sebaratnam at the University of New South Wales explained the relationship between a form of vitamin B3 and skin cancer risk. Sometimes, this vitamin is recommended to reduce the odds of skin cancer, though not everyone knows why this vitamin is chosen. The vitamin B3 type Sebaratnam mentioned was nicotinamide, also known as niacinamide. Nicotinamide isn't rare and you can get it from many dietary sources, including meat, fish, nuts, grains, and mushrooms. The precursor of this vitamin, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide or NAD+, is important for numerous energy-related activities in cells. So if your vitamin B3 levels are too low, you may develop an illness called pellagra. This may be the first time you've heard about pellagra, but it is a condition characterized by 4 Ds: dermatitis, diarrhea, dementia, and death. Why? Extremely low levels of vitamin B3 impact organs with high cellular energy needs. Affected skin for dermatitis, affected brain for dementia, affected gut for diarrhea, and if all three persist, death isn't distant. But recent studies have observed how nicotinamide could restore cellular energy to boost DNA repair, which means less risk for cells to rebel and turn into tumors. One such study was led by Professor Diona Damian at Royal Prince Alfred Hospital. Published in the New England Journal of Medicine, the ONTRAC trial revealed what other researchers might scrutinize further. In this Phase 3 double-blind randomized study, 386 patients at high risk of skin cancer received either 500 mg of nicotinamide or placebo twice a day for a year. Findings suggest that the rate of new non-melanoma skin cancer was 23% lower in the nicotinamide group than in the placebo group. Don't be too hasty about dosing yourself with nicotinamide. Besides the potential overdose, evidence is still short to make it an effective preventive measure against skin cancer. What research sees is the shortage of nicotinamide within skin cells that may help cellular dysfunction. As we age, skin gets fewer NAD+, and this may be what pushes tumors to grow. If you insist on buying supplements, Sebaratnam advises getting the nicotinamide formulation. There's also no optimal long-term dose, but the ONTRAC study used 500 mg. Have you heard about nicotinamide and pellagra? Have you taken nicotinamide supplements before? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching. Yeah.